كبور دكتور بوني يايل استلالفوت ملكت مسجانين اكربالو بمكتل يوغاندا ريبابليك بريزدانت كبور يوري كاغوتا موسيفيني ملكتاچون اندي استلالفو بتالاق اكبروت غابزالو
President of Ethiopia, the Deputy Prime Minister, the family of the late Meles Zenawi, Your Excellency, the heads of state and government who are here today, and the entire Ethiopian nation and Africa. The problem of Africa has not been resources. It has been vision, lack of vision. This has been the main problem of the African continent. In the 1960s, when we were growing up, and the 70s, intellectuals had two choices. I faced those choices myself. Either you could become a careerist and work for the system, get paid a salary, look after your family, and just lead normal life in the backward Africa of that time. Moreover, Africa, which was governed by dictatorships with a lot of brutality. Or you could opt out of the system and fight for the people. These are two choices which the generation of Meles, who are younger than us, faced, and this is the choice we who are a bit older than them faced. Now, when we faced that choice, some decided to become careerists. In fact, I remember I used to get a lot of advice from elders warning me not to be in politics. Why are you going in politics? You should just, now that you have got education, you should simply work for the system, get paid, and just look after your family. But then the question was, what will happen to Africa? What will happen to Uganda? Therefore, Meles, like some of us, he chose the option of struggle and suffering and losing a lot of comrades in the struggle. But in the process, that generation, those who chose the option of struggle, have created new conditions for the people of Africa. Here in Ethiopia, I have some figures here. When Meles came into the government, the electricity being generated in Ethiopia. Ethiopia is a very big country. Ethiopia is about 5 times the size of United Kingdom. There is a country called United Kingdom. Ethiopia is 5 times the size of the United Kingdom. But by the time Meles came into government, Ethiopia was generating 300 megawatts of electricity. 300. With 300 megawatts, you can run about, if you calculate that one factory will take 20 megawatts, how many factories are those? About 10 or what? About 15. Yeah. So that was the electricity which Ethiopia was generating when Meles came into government. What is the situation now? You are now generating 2,100 megawatts, and by 2015, after building what you call the Millennium Dam, you will be generating 10,000 megawatts. That's still low. That is still low. Because remember, United Kingdom, the one which is one-fifth of Ethiopia, they are generating 55,000 megawatts. Now, recently, when I was in the UN, I asked whether scientists have carried out research to find out that Africans don't need electricity, so that we don't bother with electricity. But you cannot have a modern country without electricity. The economic rate of growth in Ethiopia has been in double digits in recent days. If you look at the infrastructure here in Addis Ababa, it has changed so much. So that is the historic role of Meles and his colleagues. But he has died at a very young age, 57, much younger than many of us. And you may find that his death also may have been contributed to by the too much stress working in such difficult situations. But in my language, we have got two words. One word is Okutweka. Okutweka is when you die without leaving children behind. That's a bad situation. The other word is okunyeta, when your children have grown up. Meles has not kutweka, because last night I saw his children and his widow. So at a personal level, he has left children. And those children will carry out his struggle. But also, he has been part of a political party called Ethiopian People's Democratic Party. That party is there. It is also a mature party. And then there is the Ethiopian people. The ancient Ethiopian people. The Ethiopians are the only Africans who are not colonized. I congratulate you for not having been colonized. All of us in the whole of Africa were democratically colonized. We had the honor of being colonized because we were disorganized internally. But the Ethiopian people defeated colonialism. They defeated Mussolini, some other Italian adventurers of that time. At the Battle of Adowa. So, you are here. Meles has shown you the vision, together with his party. The party is there. Please, carry out that vision. This vision is the correct vision. The vision of electricity. The vision of factories. The vision of modern agriculture. The vision of an educated society. Recently, I was with him in a place called Bahir Dar. We were there, we had some meeting there, inside the country there. And he told me how they were building a big dam for not only electricity, but for irrigation. Move forward with the vision of Meles. If you do that, he will not have suffered in vain. We all shall die one day. But what matters is what contribution we make. May his soul rest in eternal peace.